You know, Kevin, Triple H not the only star. China was not with Chris Jericho on Raw or SmackDown because she was filming a TV show here in the States and also took part in one of the big variety shows, The Tonight Show.
Following contest is scheduled for Woodfall. Making his way to the ring, he weighs in at 497 pounds, Viscera.
Well, if this was on a TV show, I guess you could say it's What's My Line. A lot of people are wondering if Viscera is maybe going into business for himself as opposition to the Acolytes Protection Agency.
Yeah, we saw the Hollies take on the Acolytes on Raw in a hardcore match, and Viscera helped the Hollies pick up the victory. But a little bit of payback yesterday on SmackDown.
Yeah, the Hollies knew that something was up. Hardcore Hollies said it on SmackDown. Something was very fishy with Chris Jericho wanting to compete against both the Hollies, one arm tied behind his back, in a no disqualification match.
But Chris Jericho is the master manipulator. You had to know why 2J, the Intercontinental Champion, would have something up his sleeve, and he did. The match was barely 30 seconds old when the Acolytes came storming from the back, beat up the Hollies. It was a no disqualification match and allowed Jericho to get the victory.
So you're saying that Chris Jericho employed the services of the Acolytes Protection Agency?
No, I'm not saying that, because I don't think Chris Jericho would spend a penny on hiring the APA. What I'm saying is he manipulated the Acolytes, realizing the Acolytes had a score to settle with the Hollies. He manipulated Farouk and Bradshaw, got involved in the match so he could pick up the victory and show his bravado.
Boy, if that is indeed the case, I wonder how Farouk and Bradshaw would feel realizing they've been worked over by Y2J.
Not too good. And Funaki, who would have the quickness advantage in this one against Viscera, hammers away on the nearly 500-pounder. And there's the strength of Viscera.
Why would somebody like Funaki sign up for a match like this?
I don't know, but he walked into a sidewalk slam.
I mean, I know he has a lot to prove here in the World Wrestling Federation. He's a young, ambitious superstar with a wealth of talent. But he's giving up practically 300 pounds to Viscera.
I'm talking about superstars with a wealth of talent. Benoit, Saturn, Guerrero, Malenko. The four young men who stabbed Cactus Jack in the back this past week only to sign contracts with Triple H and Stephanie.
Well, certainly they are four opportunists. And we learned another valuable lesson, Michael, that it's not just about the friendship here in the World Wrestling Federation. It's business.
It is business. As Funaki tries to take some business to Viscera. And he's caught off the top rope by Big Vest. And Funaki might want to think twice about going to the air after that. What a slam by Viscera. You know, I understand Malenko and Saturn and Guerrero's point, along with, of course, Benoit. They have to feed their family. They need a contract. They need to make money. This is what they do. They're sports entertainers. But the way they went about it was not the right way, in my opinion.
Well, the way I look at it, Triple H is the ultimate opportunist. How smart is Triple H to realize giving these four men the opportunity to win their way into the World Wrestling Federation one week, having them lose, and to go out and probably buy their services for 50 cents on the dollar?
Kevin, I agree with you. Triple H is smart. But you got to give a lot of the credit. Oh, man.
No.
A lot of the credit to Stephanie McMahon Helmsley.
Are you saying that Stephanie was the conduit for this deal?
I think both of them were.
Well, we know Stephanie McMahon Helmsley, the acorn does not fall far from the tree. Her business savvy is inbred. She can't help it.
Well, Funaki going for the hurricane.
God, no.
In no man's land, and Viscera just planted Funaki. Funaki may need a wheelchair to get him backstage. What the hell was that?
I'm not sure.
Oh, man. The big splash. Viscera picks up the win.
Here's your winner, Viscera.
A little later on in the hour, we'll see The Rock in a special appearance on Star Trek Voyager. Plus, Michael, will also see Mark Henry go one-on-one against the Big Boss Man as the great in-ring action continues here this afternoon on Heat.
Kevin, what the...